In this video, I'll prepare the ZNA network analyzer for measurements using a WR28 waveguide interface to my DUT rather than the traditional coaxial interface. First, specify the start and stop frequency within the WR28 waveguide band. Hit the start button, set it to 26.5 gig, and the stop frequency to 40 gig. The second step is to define the WR28 waveguide connector type. Click on the calibration hard key, go to Cal Devices, and Cal Connector Types. We'll note that the WR28 connector type is currently not listed here, so we'll add that. And we'll specify that we're using a 50 ohm waveguide with 1.001 relative permittivity, and the minimum cutoff frequency is 21.077 gigahertz. Click the Close button. The third step is to define my WR28 calibration kit, including the mechanical lengths. So I'm going to click on the Cal Kits button, scroll down to the WR28 connector type, and we're going to add a new WR28 calibration kit. Let's call that WR28 Cal Kit serial number 1. We're going to uncheck the Keysight model because we're specifying the offset short as a unit of distance, not as a unit of time. Click on the Standards button, and we'll add in that offset short with a minimum frequency of 26.5 gig and a maximum frequency of 40 gig. We'll add two more standards to that and make sure that we have offset short, short, and match. Let's verify the mechanical standards for each. So for the match, you modify, we have a 0 meter delay. Verify that your match actually is a 0 meter delay. For offset short, we are using a quarter wavelength at the geometric mean frequency of 32.55 gig. That will be 2.304 millimeters if we do the math correctly. We probably actually want to measure the mechanical length of that shim using a set of calipers rather than relying on this calculation. That will give us the most accurate measurement. Click OK. Click on the short button. We'll verify this is a 0 millimeter length short. And then we'll add a two-port standard. We're going to do a zero length through. So for this through, the 26.5 gig min frequency and a 40 gig max frequency, we'll verify that it has zero length and zero loss. In this case here, we're just going to connect the waveguide on port 1 and the waveguide on port 2 together. We're done defining our calibration kit. Click the OK button. Okay, we're ready to make our calibration. Click on the Start Cal button and go to Configure Start Calibration. We'll change the default connector type to WR28, and we'll change the default cal kit to the cal kit that we just created, cal kit serial number 1. We're going to calibrate port 1 and port 2 using a UOSM calibration type, that is the unknown through open short match technique, using the standards we just defined. Click the Start Calibration button, and then we will sequentially connect the standards that we defined in our calibration kit to port 1 and 2. We can do this in any order. And finally, we'll connect port 1 and port 2 together. Click the Apply button when we're done with calibration. With the waveguide calibration complete, we are now calibrated to the WR28 waveguide flange at the input and output of the DUT. Thanks for watching.